Today is all about stock market bubbles and how they relate to cryptocurrencies.
Crypto Media Service, bringing you in-depth thoughts on cryptocurrencies.
Welcome to Crypto Media Service. I am the Golden Boy. I'll be your host today, telling you about stock market bubbles and why they are more common than you think. In these stock markets, we see a lot of bubbles. Micro bubbles, yes, but we do see a lot of them. Usually, they are pretty much dependent on every single stock and how the company is performing, but we also see a lot of them relating to other external factors such as interest rates. Throughout history, we have seen some big bubbles where the stock market have directly crashed. But if we focus on the smaller ones, which are not influenced by the company, those are the ones which are influenced by interest rate. You might see a stock going up in one market. Let's just take, for example, the Danish stock market, where the stock will go up in the period of time and suddenly change direction. This sudden change of direction might come because of a change in interest rate. When we see interest goes up, this means that there are a lot less availability of cash for investors because they cannot borrow so much money. It is simply too expensive to borrow money. And this will directly affect the stock market, where we will see mostly small dives, but we can sometimes see it taking a big dive. It does not need to crash in order to take a big dive. That we need to understand. These small crashes, well, they're normal on the stock market, or small dives. Stock markets are going up and down, and that's the nature of it. It is the same thing we see in cryptocurrencies. Of course, we saw a big bubble at the end of 2017, but we have also seen stock market taking big bubbles, hard crashes, but they recover. And when we talk about cryptocurrencies, we do not have enough data to say they recover every time. It has not been around long enough. But we see a tendency to the market to recover every time there is a bubble. Actually, what we see are bubbles mostly are formed about technologies which has viability, which has long-term perspective, and which has some form of investment involved, where we can make a lot of money. That's why every time we see a bubble, we do not have to think negatively about it. Of course, we get negative when we lose money, but if we try to take a positive spin, then a bubble is a proof of viability. This way, we can actually make some great investments once the bubble bursts, because we have that proof that it can go up there. There's a reason it can go up there. I know this was extremely hyped in 2017 by media, by influencers, and so on. But there was still a market for it at that price. I know it will take a lot of work by influencers or media if we are going to get up to that price again. But we also see that in stock market. It's another kind of influencers, but there are influencers in stock market which hypes a product and creates bubbles and actually invest out from their ability to, well, change the market into their favor. Not everyone can do that. Some of us just have to follow along and try to spot tendencies and who is influencing what and why. The why is the most important thing. And then we can see micro bubbles being created. Looking at cryptocurrencies for this year, we see it go a little up and a little down, a little up and a little down, a little up and a little down. And it has to do so. You also see normal currency do that, just not as volatile, and we have to think about that. Because if we can get the volatility out of it, but still has the momentum of up and down, then we begin to have a true currency. Remember, I am not saying Bitcoin is the future. I'm just saying cryptocurrency has a future. There is a distinct difference. Bitcoin is the household name, but it may not be the currency of tomorrow. I'm open for the possibility that it is, but I'm also open for the possibility that other currencies will take its place at some point. But right now, Bitcoin is what people know. So get out there, talk about Bitcoin, teach people that the bubble of 2017 was actually a good thing for cryptocurrencies. And yes, I do know in this series about bubbles, I skipped the tech bubbles, but that is totally on purpose because it's the same as Railroad Mania. A lot of people go in on the hype, starting some companies, trying to sell the stocks and gaining some money off that hype or making some product off that hype, which they can earn money on. So it was on purpose I skipped them, because you can just watch our videos about Railroad Mania and you will get the same information just in another package. I thank you for watching. This has been The Golden Boy on Crypto Media Service. Remember, if you like this video, click like. If you dislike, you know what to do. Remember to click subscribe, that little bell notification icon, and you get notified every time we upload a new video. Until we see each other again, bye bye, have a great time.